Welcome to Civil Engineering Ed.
Structural mechanics plus box girder evolution. So, why do bridge girders have such deep sections? And more importantly, why are they often hollow? The answer begins with physics.
When a bridge carries heavy vehicles or resists its own weight, it undergoes bending. To counter that bending moment effectively, girders must be designed with greater depth. This is directly related to how a beam deflects under load, and we can prove this with a basic engineering formula for beam deflection. Delta equals F times L, 48 times E times I, where F is the applied force or load, L is the length of the beam, E is the modulus of elasticity, a measure of material stiffness, and 1 is the moment of inertia, a geometric property that reflects the beam's resistance to bending. Now here's the key. The deeper the beam, the higher its moment of inertia and the less it bends. A practical example. Think of a ruler. Lay it flat and it bends easily. Turn it on its edge and it's far more rigid. That's exactly why girders are deep. But building solid deep beams for long spans is inefficient. Using solid rectangular sections would drastically increase material usage, self-weight, and cost. That's where hollow sections, like box girders, come in. By removing material near the neutral axis where it contributes least to stiffness and keeping it concentrated away from the center, engineers achieve greater bending resistance with less material. The moment of inertia of a hollow rectangular section is calculated by subtracting the inner rectangle from the outer, still delivering high strength with significantly lower weight. To prevent buckling in these thin walls, stiffeners are added. This principle is what led to the development of I-beams and eventually to box girders, which take it a step further. The box design links to vertical webs with continuous top and bottom flanges, forming a closed shape that resists twisting and buckling far better than an open section like an I-beam. When wider ducts are needed to support more lanes of traffic, box sections, either rectangular or trapezoidal, are ideal. They provide a uniform platform, better aerodynamics, and higher structural efficiency. Although early box girder applications faced failures due to limited understanding, today's engineers use reinforced and prestressed concrete box segments, prefabricated off-site and installed with precision. Those tension cables inside the girder boost strength, reduce bending, and help span greater distances, all while keeping the structure hollow and efficient. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Civil Engineering Ed.